Okay, children, a very good morning to all of you. Children, in the last class we were discussing about parallel lines and the chapter was completed. Everything about parallel lines had been discussed in the previous class. Today, one problem also I had done. Let us do few more problems to have a better understanding of the chapter parallel lines. Okay, look at the question. Here is a question. Suppose look at the figure. In this figure, you see this AB, this CD, you see AD and BC, they intersect each other at the point O. AD and BC, you see AD and BC intersect at O. Suppose this is angle 1, this is angle 2. Angle BAO, you see angle BAO equal to angle CDCO, this angle. Angle 1 equal to angle 2, C. That means you are given angle BAO DCO. Angle BAO equal to angle DCO. BAO means this angle, DCO means this angle. Suppose angle 1 and angle 2. These two are equal given. And what else given? OD equal to OC. You are also given OD equal to OC. So OD equal to OC and angle 1 equal to angle 2. It is given. How will we prove so that AB parallel to CD. So how to prove that AB parallel to CD? Let us see. Okay. Now this angle equal to this angle, it is given. Suppose angle 1, angle 2. Now OD and OC are also given equal. So how will we prove that AB, this line segment AB and CD, they are parallel to each other? You see. How to solve this particular question? See children. Now we are given angle 1 and 2. Suppose this angle is 3. Let angle ODC be 3. Now see, since OD and OC are equal, therefore angle 2 and angle 3 must be equal, because you know in a triangle if two sides are equal, they are opposite angle. This is isosceles triangle. ODC is isosceles triangle. If two angles are equal, you see, if two sides are equal, then their opposite angles must be equal. Angles opposite to equal sides of an isosceles triangle are equal. So if OD equal to OC, then angle 2 and 3 must be equal. But you see, but angle 2 is equal to angle 1. It is given. This is given. So you see, angle 2 equal to angle 3, but angle 2 is angle equal to angle 1. That means angle 1 and 3 must be equal. See, this angle and this angle. Therefore, angle 1 equal to angle 3. But see children, look at angle 1 and angle 3. What angles are they? Angle 1 and angle 3. What angles are they? They are clearly alternate interior angles with this transversal. See, with the transversal AD and the lines AB and CD, angle 1 and 3, they form a pair of what angles? Alternate interior angles, and they are equal. So what will be our next step? But these are what angles? These are alternate interior angles. So, as a pair of alternate interior angles is equal or same, then definitely AB and CD must be parallel. Therefore, AB parallel to CD. See, because we know when a transversal intersects two parallel lines, each pair of alternate interior angles same. So, what is the converse? If one pair of alternate interior angles is same or equal, then definitely the two lines will be parallel. These two are alternate interior angles with the transversal AB and the lines AB and CD. So definitely AB and CD will be parallel because angle 1 and 3 are equal. Okay. So in this way you can solve this question. Now see, let us discuss another problem. Suppose you are given, look at another question. Suppose you are given a figure like this. Suppose you are given your ABC. Let us produce it up to D, A, B, C. BC is produced up to D. Now see C, E. Look at. This is C, E. This is the figure. Now this angle is given say 75 degree. And this angle is given say 40 degree. See. Angle ECD given 40 degree. Angle BAC given 75 degree. And we are given CE parallel to CE parallel to BA. See, look at children. So, in this figure, what is given? The ray CE is parallel to BA. Okay. This angle, angle ECD 40 degree and angle BAC 75 degree. So what is the question? The question is find the other two triangles. You see, that means you find this angle and this angle. Other two angles of this triangle. You see, you are given one angle only, angle A. How to find angle B and angle C in this triangle? Okay. So how to do this thing? This question particularly how to solve it? See, this can be solved in many ways, children. One of the ways I am saying, see, now look at B A and C E. See, B A and C E. They are given what? C E parallel to B A. So C E parallel to B A. And what about B D? B D is the transversal. Clearly, C E parallel to C. See, if C E is parallel to B A, then this will be the transversal. And if this is the transversal, then this angle E C D and angle B, they form a what angle? A pair of what angles? Corresponding angle. You see, this one, CE parallel to BA, and this is the transversal line. BD is the transversal line. So this 40 degree and angle B, they must be what? They must form a pair of what angles? Corresponding angle. So as they form a pair of corresponding angles, so definitely this angle will be 40 degree. Okay. So we got angle ABC 40 degree. Now you can easily find angle C by using angle sum property, because this is 75, this is 40. So 75 plus 40, how much you find out? Subtract it from 180, because sum of three angles is what? Sum of three interior angles of a triangle is 180 degree. So if this is 75 and this is 40, then this angle will be 65 degree. Okay, you can easily find. You can also find another way. You see, now look at this one. This one 75. This angle is 75. So what about this angle? How much will be angle ABE? Angle ABE, look at, these are alternate interior angles. Since you see, CE parallel to BA, so SE will be the transversal. See, this is another way. CE parallel to BA, it is given, and SE is transversal. So definitely this angle, angle ACE and angle BAC, they will form a pair of alternate interior angles. So if this is 75, this will be 75. Now if this is 75, if this angle is 75, now 75 plus 40, the total angle is how much? It is 150. Now you can easily find this angle, angle ACD, but it will be a lengthy one. It will be, the process will be bit lengthier, okay? So this will be 65, now this is 75, this is 65. So this will be automatically 40 degree by angle sum property. So whichever way you feel convenient, you can do, okay? Let us do it by the fast way. See, so CE parallel to BA and BD transversal. See, and BD transversal. This is the transversal line. Okay. Therefore, angle ABC. Look at ABC and ECD. ECD angle. They must be equal. Why? Because they are corresponding angles. Okay. So, but you see, angle ECD is given how many degree? 40 degree. So therefore, ABC equal to 40 degree. We got this angle 40 degree. Now we can easily find angle ACB. Therefore, by angle sum property, ASP, angle sum property of triangle ABC, we can easily find angle ACB. How to find angle ACB? It will be sum of three angles is 180 degree. Okay, that is known as your angle sum property. So it will be 180 minus angle ABC plus angle BAC. This is 180 minus ABC, how many degree? 40 degree. This is 75 degree. So this is 180 minus 511. 115, it is 65 degree. See. So angle C will be 65 degree and angle B will be how many degree? Your 40 degree. Okay. So in this way, we can find the remaining two angles of the triangle. Children, I hope these two problems which I discussed, you must have understood. Okay. So we will also discuss more problems about parallel lines in the next class. Okay. Thank you.